Some nights I dreamt of Camelot. And Lancelot.
Lancelot was fatally flawed. Destined never to find the Grail.
Still, he was the greatest knight of all.
Delights to weave the mirror's magic sights, for often through the silent nights, a funeral with plumes and lights and music went to Camelot.
By the side of the beaver night, long fields of barley and of rye, the cloth of wild meet the sky. Through the field, the road runs. Down the people go, gazing where the lilies blow, round an island there below, the island of Shalott. Willows white and aspens quiver, little breezes dusk and shiver, through the wave that runs forever, by the four grey walls and four grey towers overlook a space of flowers, and the silent island bowers the Lady of Shalott. Only reapers reaping early in among the beaded. By the moon, the reaper weary, piling sheaves in upland's airy, listening whispers and hears the fairy, the Lady of Shalott. She weaves by night and day a magic web with colors gay. She has heard a whisper say a curse is on her if she stayed to look down to Camelot. She knows not what the curse may be, and so she weaves steadily. Little other moving through a mirror clear, there hangs before her all the year. Shadows of the world appear. There she sees the highway near, winding down to Camelot. And sometimes through the mirror blue, the knights come riding two and two. She hath no loyal knight and true, the Lady of Shalott. But in her web she still delights to weave the mirror's magic sights. For often through the silent nights, a funeral with plumes and with lights and music went to Camelot. Oh, when the moon was overhead, came two young lovers lately wed. I'm half sick of shadows, she said, the Lady of Shalott. shot from her bodies. He rode between the barley sheaves. The sun came dancing through the leaves and flamed upon the brazen greaves of Baldur's and Lancelot. A Red Cross knight forever kneeled to a lady in his shield that sparkled on the yellow field beside remote Shalott. His broad clear brow in sunlight glowed, on burnished hooves his war horse trod, from underneath his helmet flowed his coal black curls as on he rode, as he rode down to from the bank and from the river. He flashed into the crystal mirror, Tira Lira by the river, sighed Sir Lancelot. She left the web, she left the loom, she made three paces through the gloom. She saw the helmet and the pool. She looked down to Camelot. Out flew the web and floated wide. The mirror cracked from side to side. The curses come upon me, cried the Lady of Shalott. Stormy east wind straining, the pale yellow woods were waning, the broad stream in his banks complaining, heavily the low sky raining over towered Camelot. Down she came and found a boat beneath the willow left afloat, and round about the prow she down the river's dim expanse, like some bold Serena trance, seeing all his own mischance. With a glassy countenance, she looked to Camelot. And at the closing of the day, she loosed the chain, down she lay. Broad stream bore her far away, the Lady of Shalott. As she reached upon the tide, the first house by the water's side, singing in her song she died, the Lady of Shalott. And under tower and balcony, by garden wall and gallery, a gleaming shape she floated by, dead pale between the houses nigh, silent into Camelot. And out upon the wharfs they came, knight and burgher, lord and dame, and round the prow they read her name, the Lady of Shalott.
with you. I need you.